Hi, welcome back to RVing DIY Newbie to Pro. And today we're going to talk about the musties. You ever walk into a room in your RV or motor coach and you smell the musties and you don't know where it's coming from? Well, we had that problem and I'm going to show you how we dealt with it successfully. In the back in our bedroom area, we have a cabinet, and in the cabinet is where when Jen would open up, she continually smelled mildew. And we're trying to figure out where this mildew is coming from. So what we did was we went in the back, opened all the drawers and took them out, opened the cabinets and looked around. And I'm going to take you back and show you where it was and what we did. And then I'll go over the two solutions that we had for the problem. All right, here we go.
Okay. All right, now we're back in our bedroom. This was the cabinet area that we were having the problem with. You could always smell it was musty back here for some reason. We weren't really sure why. This cabinet and one on the upper, on the other side of the bed had the same problem, but this one was far worse. So what we did was we opened up all the cabinets and we took out the drawers and we removed them. And what we found, and I cleaned it off since then, there was mildew all on the side of the drawer here. It was rather disgusting actually, and it really did stink. So the next step was to figure out, okay, we have moisture, where is it coming from? So I got the flashlight and I looked all underneath and I could not find a leak. I found, and a good way to look for leaks is when it's dark inside and light outside, is just look for light. If you see light, then you know there's air coming through. If you know there's air coming through, there's certainly going to be water coming through if it rains. I didn't see any light, and I then went up to my roof and I walked around the roof and I looked at the tape marks and where the seams were, and everything was intact and we didn't have a problem there either. So the next conclusion I came up with was this back wall area is not insulated very well because we're standing over the engine compartment. It's noise proofed, but it's not really insulated for temperature. And back in this area with the air conditioner on, it would be cool in this room. But as the sun down here in Texas is baking on us on the outside at 90, 95 degrees and the humidity is about 80%, it gives us a heat temperature index of about 110, 115 degrees. And you have the hot air back here because it's closed in, and the cold air out here coming together, and it causes condensation. And it was causing condensation on the hard wooden surfaces, and that's where the smell was coming from. So I didn't have a leak, so it was nothing to seal up on the leak. I had condensation coming in on the inside from the air conditioning and the hot heat outside. So what do you do? Well, we came up with a simple solution. There's two that we're gonna go over, and one of them is, we hung bags to collect moisture in the cabinetry. And you can see that's full of water. And what that does is, there's a chemical here that takes the moisture and then it absorbs it from the air that drains it down into the bag. Well, it's time to change this bag, so I am gonna do that next. Down below wasn't as easy because this is a sealed in area. So what we did here was, I put a hook. All right, now if you're looking inside, you can see the hook there and it's screwed into the wall. It's a good size hook. And that bag's hanging there. And what that does is when the area is confined, it's gonna grab moisture too. So I'm gonna pull that one out and we're gonna take a look and see how full that one is. Now, holy cow, look at that. That one's really full of water. So that's doing its job too. See how it's sloshing around? And once again, there's nothing left up top. So that's 2 weeks worth of collection. So that needs to be changed out too. So I'm going to go over these bags, where you can get them, and then there's another simple thing that we do here too. And that is, when during the day, we won't shut the door all the way. We'll have the bags in there, we'll keep the drawer propped open a little bit, and this drawer propped open a little bit, so you get some airflow, and it's not such a temperature difference. Some of the cold air will migrate in, and it's not such a shock between the cold and hot air, and the condensation goes away. So that's how we solved this issue back here, because this was a serious issue and had lots of moisture. So we used the damper-in product and it worked. Okay, this was the second cabinet that had a problem, but here when I opened it up and looked around, this is where we keep some sheets and shoes and so forth. There was no obvious mildew, so it wasn't a heavy moisture area. It was just an area that had lack of fresh air once again, and so it would build up a little bit of the musty smell. So in this situation, I didn't feel one of those bags was needed. So what we did was we just went out and got a El Cheapo box of baking soda. I didn't even get the expensive stuff. I got the store brand at Walmart. The baking soda cut the lid off so that it was open to the air. And we just stuck it in the corner of the cabinet. and then you shut it, and that'll absorb the odors, and it works great. Same thing if you have a refrigerator and you have smell in your refrigerator, do the same thing. Take some baking soda, open the box, you take the top off, put it in there, and it'll keep it fresh smelling without adding any problem chemicals or expensive remedies. All right, now we're back up front again. You saw what the problem was, you saw the easy solutions that we had. The one bag, the Damprid products, which is this. This is the Damprid product that we had hanging on the curtain, on the clothes rod, and on the hook on the side. As you can see, it filled up with tons of water, and it was successful, and it works great. Those I buy from Amazon, and it comes in a 3-pack. It's called Damprid. Now, I am gonna give some advice on this, and that is that it does have a scent to it. And if you read all the reviews, some people don't mind it. Some people say it's really bad. I think the scent is not too bad. It's better than the musties. And as time goes on, the scent diminishes a little bit. But it does work. It does collect water. If you read some of the reviews about the water collection, it said the product does not work. Well, all I can tell you is you can see the results here in the bag from hanging it up. So obviously it does work. And yes, this is the fresh scent version. And yes, it does have an odor to it. Try it and see if you can. And then as far as the other cabinet, we use the baking soda. Baking soda you can get in any supermarket. It's anywhere between 50 and a dollar a box. Just cut the lid off, stick it in there, and you'll be good to go. And you'll be all set, and those musties will go away. So we'll wipe them out, and you'll have some nice fresh smelling RVs again. Well, thank you for watching us. Don't forget to like us at the bottom and subscribe. The reason why you want to subscribe is you don't want to miss anything that we've discovered and give you new information on, and it makes your RVing easier. And learn by our mistakes and grow and have a successful time. Thanks for watching RV DIY Newbie to Pro, and we'll see you next time. Bye.